वेलकम बैक एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 5, वुमन चेंज द वर्ल्ड। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी सॉ हाउ वुमेन्स वर्क इन द होम इज नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज वर्क। वी ऑल्सो रेड हाउ डूइंग हाउस होल्ड वर्क एंड टेकिंग केयर ऑफ फैमिली मेम्बर्स इज अ फुल टाइम जॉब एंड देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक आवर्स एट विच इट बिगिन्स और एंड्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लुक एट वर्क आउटसाइड द होम एंड अंडरस्टैंड हाउ सम ऑक्यूपेशंस आर सीन टू बी मोर सूटेबल फॉर मैन देन फॉर वुमेन। वी विल ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट How women struggle for equality. Getting an education was and still is one way in which new opportunities were created for women. This chapter will also briefly trace the different types of efforts made by the women's movement to challenge discrimination in more recent years. So we'll learn this now. So you can draw some images here. Farmer, factory worker, nurse, teacher, pilot and scientist. See what images your class drew by filling in the table below. Add up the number of male and female image separately for each occupation. So here is the male and female image. You can see how many students drew, how many male image and how many female images. So here women are working. 83.6% of working women in India are engaged in agricultural work. Their work include painting, weeding, planting, weeding, harvesting and threshing. Yet when think of a farmer, we only think as a man. Rosie Mann's class had 30 children. She did the same exercise in her class and here is the result. So in Rosie Mann's class, 30 children answered the category with male and female images. Teacher, male image is 5 and 25 female image. Okay, farmer, all were male images, 0 were female images. And factory workers 25, 5, nurse 0 and all were female images as nurse. Scientist 25 and female as 5 and pilot 27 and 3 female images. So here is the students who drew male and female images. Fewer opportunities and rigid expectations. A lot of the children in Rosie Mann's class drew women as nurse and men as army officers. The reason they did this is because they feel that outside the home too, women are good at only certain jobs. For example, many people believe that women make better nurses because they are more patient and gentle. This is linked to women's roles within the family. Similarly, it is believed that science requires a technical mind and girls and women are not capable of dealing with technical things. So here is a stereotype. Because so many people believe in these stereotypes, many girls do not get the same support that boys do to study and train to become doctors and engineers. In most families, once a girl finishes school, they are encouraged by the family to see marriage as their main aim in life. So breaking the stereotypes, engine drivers are men, but 27-year-old Lakshmi Lakra from a poor tribal family in Jharkhand has begun to change things. She is the first woman engine driver for Northern India. So you can see Lakshmi Lakra driving the train engine. Lakshmi's parents are not literate, but they struggled and overcame many hardships to make sure their children got an education. Lakshmi studied in a government school. Even in school, Lakshmi helped with the housework and did odd jobs. She studied hard and did well, and then went on to get a diploma in electronics. She then took the railway board exam and passed it on her first attempt. So she passed the exam in first attempt and got the job. Lakshmi says, I love challenges, and the moment somebody says it is not for girls, I make sure I go ahead and do it. So she is very motivated. Lakshmi has had to do this several times in her life. When she wanted to take electronics, when she rode motorcycles at the polytechnic, and when she decided to become an engine driver, her philosophy is simple. As long as I am having fun without harming anyone, as long as I am doing well and helping my parents, why should I not lead a lifestyle of my choice? So all the best to Lakshmi Lakra, adopted from driving her train by Neeta Lal Women's Features Service. It is important to understand that we live in a society in which all children face pressures from the world around them. Sometimes these comes in the form of demands from adults. At other times, they can just be because of unfair teasing by our own friends. Boys are pressurized to think about getting a job that will pay a good salary. They are also teased and bullied if they do not behave like other boys. You may remember that in your class 6 book, you read about how boys at an early age are encouraged not to cry in front of others. So boys are encouraged to not cry in front of others. Xavier was happy with the result of his class 10th board exams. Though his marks in science and maths were not high, he had done well in his favorite subjects, history and languages. When his parents saw his report card, however, they did not look pleased at all. My goodness, Xavier, you manage only 65% in maths. Your marks in physics are low too. I know, Mama, but it's okay because I don't want to take maths or science. I want to study history. Why do you want to take history? Think about your future. You have to get a good job. History will not help. It has no scope. But I don't like maths or science, said Xavier. So here, be sensible, son. Take maths. And you can study computers side by side. The job market for computers is very good, says Xavier's mom. Learning for change. Going to school is an extremely important part of your life. As more and more children enter school every year, we begin to think that it is normal for all children to go to school. Today, it is difficult for us to imagine that school and learning could be seen as out of bounds or not appropriate for some children. But in the past, the skill of reading and writing was known to only a few. Most children learned the work their family or elder sir did. For girls, the situation was worse. In communities that taught sons to read and write, daughters were not allowed to learn the alphabet. Even in families where skills like pottery, weaving and crafts were taught, the contribution of daughters and women was only seen as supportive. For example, in the pottery trade, women collected the mud and prepared the earth for the pots, but since they did not operate the wheel, they were not seen as potters. So here is a picture of Ramabai, who lived between 1858 to 1922, shown above with her daughter, championed the cause of women's education. She never went to school but learned to read and write from her parents. She was given the title Pandita because she could read and write Sanskrit. A remarkable achievement as women then were not allowed such knowledge. She went on to set up a mission in Khedgaon near Pune in 1898, where widows and poor women were encouraged not only to become literate but to be independent. They were taught a variety of skills from carpentry to running a printing press, skills that are not usually taught to girls even today. The printing press can be seen in the picture on the top left corner. Ramabai's mission is still active today. In the 19th century, many new ideas about education and learning emerged. School became more common, and communities that had never learned reading and writing started sending their children to school. But there was a lot of opposition to educating girls even then. Yet many women and men made efforts to open schools for girls. Women struggled to learn to read and write. Let us read about the experience of Rashasundari Devi, who lived between 1800 to 1890, who was born in West Bengal some 200 years ago. At the age of 60, she wrote her autobiography in Bangla. Her book titled Amar Jeevan is the first known autobiography written by an Indian woman. Rashasundari Devi was a housewife from a rich landlord's family. At that time, it was believed that if a woman learned to read and write, she would bring bad luck to her husband and become a widow. Despite this, she taught herself how to read and write in secret well after her marriage. So here is another section. Learning to read and write led some women to question the situation of women in society. They wrote stories, letters, and autobiographies describing their own experiences of inequality. In their writings, they also imagined new way of thinking and living for both men and women. So I would start working at dawn, and I would still be at it until well beyond midnight. I had no rest in between. I was only 14 years old at the time. I came to nurture a great longing. I would learn to read and write, read a religious manuscript. How unlucky in those days women were not educated. Later, I began to resent my own thoughts. What is wrong with me? Women do not read. How will I do it? Then I had a dream. I was reading the manuscript of Chaitanya Bhagavat, the life of a saint, Lord Chaitanya. Later in the day, एज आई सेट कुकिंग इन द किचन आई हर्ड माई हस्बैंड से टू माई एल्डेस्ट सन, बिपिन आई हैव लेफ्ट माई चैतन्य भागवत हियर, वेन आई आस्क फॉर इट ब्रिंग इट हियर ब्रिंग इट इन, ही लेफ्ट द बुक देयर एंड वेंट अवे। वेन द बुक हैड बीन टेकन इन साइड आई सीक्रेटली टुक आउट अ पेज एंड हिड इट केयरफुली, इट वॉज अ जॉब हाइडिंग फॉर इट, फॉर नो बडी मस्ट फाइंड इट इन माई हैंड्स। माई एल्डेस्ट सन वॉज प्रैक्टिसिंग हिज अल्फाबेट्स एट दैट टाइम, आई हैड वन ऑफ देम एज वेल। एट टाइम्स आई वेंट ओवर दैट ट्राइंग टू मैच लेटर्स फ्रॉम द पेजेस विद द लेटर्स दैट आई रिमेंबर्ड। आई ऑल्सो ट्राई टू मैच द वर्ड्स विद दोज दैट आई वुड हियर इन द कोर्स ऑफ माई डेज। विद ट्रेमेंडस केयर एंड एफर्ट एंड ओवर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम आई लर्न हाउ टू रीड। सो शी रेड चैतन्य भागवत स्टोरी ऑफ अ ग्रेट सेंट लॉर्ड चैतन्य। सो हियर इज अनदर स्टोरी, रोकिया शिखावत हुसैन एंड हर ड्रीम्स अबाउट लैंड लेडी लैंड। रोकिया शिखावत हुसैन 1882-1932 वॉज बॉर्न इन टू अ रिच फैमिली हु ओन्ड अ लॉट ऑफ लैंड। दो शी न्यू हाउ टू रीड एंड राइट उर्दू, शी वॉज स्टॉप्ड फ्रॉम लर्निंग बांग्ला एंड इंग्लिश। इन दोज डेज इंग्लिश वॉज सीन एज अ लैंग्वेज दैट वुड एक्सपोज गर्ल्स टू न्यू आइडियाज विच पीपल थॉट वेर नॉट करेक्ट फॉर देम। देयर फॉर इट वॉज मोस्टली बॉय हु वेर टॉट इंग्लिश। रोकिया लर्न टू रीड एंड राइट बंगला एंड इंग्लिश विद द सपोर्ट ऑफ हर एल्डर ब्रदर एंड एन एल्डर सिस्टर। शी वेंट टू बिकेम एन राइटर। शी रोट अ रिमार्केबल स्टोरी टाइटल सुल्ताना'ज ड्रीम इन 1905 टू प्रैक्टिस हर इंग्लिश स्किल्स वेन शी वॉज मियरली 25 ईयर्स ओल्ड। दिस स्टोरी इमेजिन अ वुमेन कॉल्ड सुल्ताना हु रीचेस अ प्लेस कॉल्ड लैंड लेडी सॉरी रीचेस अ प्लेस ईयर हाँ रीचेस अ प्लेस कॉल्ड लैंड लेडी लैंड लेडी लैंड इज अ प्लेस वे वुमेन हैड द फ्रीडम टू स्टडी वर्क एंड क्रिएट इन्वेंशंस लाइक कंट्रोलिंग रेन फ्रॉम द क्लाउड एंड फ्लाइंग एयर कार्स। इन द लेडी लैंड द मैन हैड बीन सेंड इन टू सेक्लूशन, देयर एग्रेसिव गन्स एंड अदर वेपन्स ऑफ वॉर डिफीटेड बाय द ब्रेन पावर ऑफ वुमेन। एज सुल्ताना ट्रेवल्स इन लेडी लैंड विद सिस्टर सैरा शी अवेक्स टू रियलाइज दैट शी वॉज ओनली ड्रीमिंग। एज यू कैन सी रुकाया शेखावत हुसैन वॉज ड्रीमिंग ऑफ वुमेन फ्लाइंग प्लेन्स एंड कार्स इवन बिफोर गर्ल्स वेयर बींग अलाउड टू डू गो टू स्कूल। दिस वॉज द वे इन विच एजुकेशन एंड लर्निंग हैज चेंज रुकायाज ओन लाइफ। रुकाया डिड नॉट स्टॉप एट गेटिंग एजुकेशन जस्ट फॉर हरसेल्फ। हर एजुकेशन गेव अ पावर नॉट ओनली टू ड्रीम एंड राइट बट ऑल्सो टू डू मोर टू हेल्प अदर्स गर्ल्स गो टू स्कूल एंड टू बिल्ड देयर ओन ड्रीम्स। इन 1910 शी स्टार्टेड अ स्कूल फॉर गर्ल्स इन कोलकाता एंड टू दिस डे द स्कूल इज स्टिल फंक्शनिंग। After learning, so it is over. After learning the alphabet, Rajsundari Devi was able to read the Chaitanya Bhagavat. Through her own writing, she also gave the world an opportunity to read about women's life in those days. Rajsundari Devi wrote about her everyday life experience in details. There were days when she did not have a moment rest, no time even to sit down and eat. Unlike Rajsundari Devi and Rokaya Hussain, who were not allowed to learn and read and write, large number of girls attend school in India today. Despite this, there continues to be many girls who leave school for reason of poverty, inadequate schooling facilities and discrimination. Providing equal schooling facilities to children from all communities and class background and particularly girls continues to be a challenge in India. Schooling education today. Today both boys and girls attend school in large numbers. Yet as we see, there still remains difference between the education of boys and girls. India has census every 10 years, which counts the whole population of the country. It also gathers detail about the people living in India, their age, schooling, what work they do and so on. We use this information to measure many things like the number of literate people and the ratio of men and women. According to 1961 census, about 40% of all boys and men 7 years old and above were literate. That is, they could at least write their names, compared to just 15% of all girls and women. So number is very low. In the most recent census of 2011, these figures have grown to 82% for boys and men and 65% for girls and women. This means that the proportion of both men and women who are now able to read and have at least some amount of schooling has increased. But as you can see, the percentage of the male group is still higher than the female group. The gap has not gone away. Here is the table that shows the percentage of girls and boys who leave schools for different social groups, including scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, SC and ST. So you can see the level, primary, upper primary is from 6 to 8 and secondary from 9 to 10. And primary is 1 to 5. So you can see the people, boys and girls leaving. So you can see in primary 4.36 and girls 3.88. Total is 4.13. So number is there, total number. And another section there is SC caste, and which boys are 4.71, 420 girls, and 4.4346 total SC girls, boys and girls. And here in ST, 7.02 boys and 6.84 girls, and total of 6.93. So you can see ST guys in primary boys and girls are leaving, so many people are leaving school and leaving education and doing something else. And in upper primary also, you can see ST is in higher number. You can see 8.48 and 8.471, and total is 8.59. And in the primary secondary schooling, many people are leaving, or 17.21 in all section and 16.88 in girls. And total becomes 17.06. Here also in SC 19.64, and here 19.05, 19.36. And here is a record for ST 24.94 and 24.40 and 24.68. So many people are dropping out every year. You have probably noticed in the above table that SC and ST girls leave school at a rate that is higher than the category all girls. This means that girls who are from Dalit, SC and Adivasi ST backgrounds are less likely to remain in school. The 2011 census also found that Muslim girls are less likely than SC and ST girls to complete primary school. While a Muslim girl is likely to stay in school for around 3 years, girls from other communities spend around 4 years in school. So Muslim girls are even lesser in number as in education. There are several reasons why children from Dalit, Adivasi and Muslim communities leave school. In many parts of our country, especially in rural and poor area, there may not even be proper schools nor teachers who teach on a regular basis. If a school is not close to people's home and there is no transport like bus or vans, parents may not be willing to send their girls to school. So this is clear. Many families are too poor and unable to bear the cost of educating all their children. Boys may get preference in this situation. Many children also leave school because they are discriminated against by their teacher and classmates. Just like Om Prakash Valmiki was, you have seen in the previous chapter, he was discriminated by teacher and was forced to sweep the school. So here you can see, here is a table. What this is showing, figure of the table, convert the figure of primary class children who leave school into a bar diagram. 2% have already been converted for you in the bar diagram on the left. So you can see the bar diagram, all boys 4.36 and all girls SC, all ST boys 7.2. So you can put that, plot it in the graph from the above table. Women's movement. School and girls now have the right to study and go to school. There are other spheres like legal reform, violence and health where the situation of women and girls has improved. These changes have not happened automatically. Women individually and collectively have struggled to bring about these changes. This struggle is known as the women's movement. Individual women and women's organization from different part of the country are part of the movement. Many men support the women's movement as well. The diversity, passion and efforts of those involved makes it very vibrant movement. Different strategies have been used to spread awareness, fight discrimination and seek justice. Here is some of the glimpse of this struggle. So there is campaigning work, campaigns to fight discrimination and violence against women as an important part of the women's movement. Campaigns have also led to new laws being passed. A new law was made in 2006 to give women who face physical and mental violence within their homes, also called domestic violence, some legal protection. So who are the victims of domestic violence are given legal protection. So similarly, efforts made by the women's movement led to the Supreme Court to formulate guidelines in 1997 to protect women against sexual harassment at workplace and within the educational institutions. So here is a picture of Satya Rani, an active member of the women's movement, sitting on the steps of the Supreme Court, surrounded by legal files gathered during the course of long legal battle to seek justice for her daughter who was murdered for dowry. So you can see her daughter was murdered for dowry, and here is the case files beside her. इन द 1980s, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वुमेंस ग्रुप्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री स्पोक आउट अगेंस्ट डाउरी डीड टैक्स. केस ऑफ यंग ब्राइड्स बीन मर्डर्ड बाय देयर इन लॉज और हस्बैंड्स ग्रीडी फॉर मोर डाउरी. सो मेनी पीपल्स आर ग्रीडी फॉर डाउरी एंड दे मर्डर्ड यंग ब्राइड्स. वुमेंस ग्रुप्स ब्रिंग दिस केसेस टू जस्टिस. सॉरी, वुमेन ग्रुप्स स्पोक आउट अगेंस्ट द फेलियर टू ब्रिंग दिस केसेस टू जस्टिस. दे डिड सो बाय कमिंग ऑन टू द स्ट्रीट्स, अप्रोचिंग द कोर्ट्स एंड बाय शेयरिंग इन्फॉर्मेशन. इवेंचुअली दिस बिकेम अ पब्लिक इशू इन द न्यूज पेपर एंड सोसाइटी, एंड द डाउरी लॉ वे चेंज टू पनिश फैमिलीज हु सीक डाउरी. सो डाउरी वॉज एबोलिश्ड एंड हु वेर आस्किंग डाउरीज वॉज पनिश्ड. Rising awareness. An important part of the women's movement's work is to raise public awareness on women's rights issue. Their message has been spread through street plays, songs, and public meetings. So protesting is also there. The women's movement raises its voice when violations against women take place, or for example, when a law or policy act against their interests. People rallies and demonstrations are very powerful way for drawing attention to injustice. So you can see rallies are being done, showing solidarity. The women's movement is also about showing solidarity with other women and causes. So below is on 8 March, International Women Day, women all over the world came together to celebrate and renew their struggles. And above, the women are holding up candles to demonstrate the solidarity between the people of India and Pakistan. Every year on 14 August, several thousand people gather in Wagah on the border of India and Pakistan and hold a cultural program. So you can see, so here are many women. So here the chapter is finished, and we will start the next chapter in the next class. Thank you.